going to, we are learning Siman Kuf Kaf Chet in Ola Chaim's 128 for all those who are looking up in the English Islam Quran. We're doing Siyif Lamed. The Shulchan Aruch speaks about over here a concept where certain Kohanim, although they are kosher Kohanim, and seemingly they should be able to become Kohanim without a problem, but because they have certain type of mumim, blemishes, defects, that Hashem has created them and Hashem has given them this as a package for life, things come with a package. Everybody comes over here, comes with his own pekalach, has a little bag, a goodie bag that he brings with him that is there for his own benefit. And sometimes people have to learn how to build themselves on it, how to capitalize on these things and not how to fall because of these things. And what we're talking about is the following concept. The people have a certain type of defects where they have, let's say, they have discoloration of skin, or let's say they have a lot of warts, or let's say they have certain type of things that they have on their faces or on their hands, right? And some people, if they take, when they do Birat Kohanim without shoes and they have no socks on, let's say they have some certain things on their feet, these kind of people will not be able to go out to do Birkat Kohanim. And also, people who, let's say, who are working with certain type of paint, and the paint is not washable at all, and the paint gets stuck on their hands, and these things normally would bring up or arouse a curiosity of people to look at them. Now we know that according to Halakha, when the Kohanim are doing the Birkat Kohanim, nobody's allowed to look at them. We don't look at them at all. And Chazal say those who look at the Kohanim as if they're looking at the Shekhinah, and Chazal, they're going to come to a point of losing their eyesight. So it's very important that we cover ourselves and we don't look at the Kohanim at the time when they're doing Birkat Kohanim. But because of these people, they have certain defects, certain problems, people will be curious to know, to see, like, see, I'm Chelichi. Is it like this, is it like this? Toba, yeah, Ras Bechudash, or whatever the kind of stuff, huh?
Even natural
blemishes. Even if it's not natural blemishes, but like, for example, warts. A guy has, or let's say, has white spots all over. Or Bishnabu works down over here, a case where people have freckles. And they have certain freckles where it's kanapati, onto supsur, you know, rigi. And he, when the summertime comes, you see all his freckles come out, and then it looks too much. And people are curious to see, like, you know, like saying, wow, to such an extent, people have this kind of thing. So Gemara says to go ahead and say that these kind of people should not be able to come to a point of doing Birkat Kohanim. Because people who, or let's say a person that is blind, his eyes don't open up, or whatever it is that, or let's say he has constantly drooling saliva. You know, he drools. When he was constantly, all these kind of things would make arouse people's curiosity to look at him and to stare at him at the time when he's doing Birkat Kohanim. And this will bring about problems to people. So therefore they say, according to Halakha, that people should go ahead and such people should not do Birkat Kohanim. Unless, here comes the unless part. Unless he is already in the city for more than 30 days. And people will look at people for 30 days and say, "I was a daspi ilo." Everybody knows about him already. Everybody, kulam mikilubo, not say histakeleter, kulam yudim. Everybody knows. Like the famous story with Rabbi Akiva. Rabbi Akiva wants to go to learn Torah. He comes to the yeshiva to learn alibet. And he was 40 years old. And as he was 40 years old, he wanted to come to yeshiva to learn. All the little kids in the head of 3, 4, 5 years old started laughing. Look at Akiva. Here, Akiva, 40 years old, came to cheder to learn. Kulam to hagimana. Everybody's laughing at him. And it ends up being that his wife tells him, "What's the problem? You don't want to go to learn because everybody's laughing at you? Come, where's your donkey? Bring him." He brought the donkey, so she went ahead, she said, "Take dirt, so fresh dirt, obviously, not the garbage dirt that they have. You know, organic. Put it on the back of the donkey and plant a flower inside there. You plant the flower, it's going to blossom and grow, and it's going to, well, it was a spring season." And she tells him, "Okay, now take this donkey and go to the marketplace." He goes to the marketplace, everybody's laughing. Look, Akiva, chavor osho kat Akiva. To such an extent, Akiva da amaret, he's chavor, his donkey has a flower growing off its back. Everybody's laughing. He comes back home, kaka. You know, all embarrassed. He tells his wife, "No, how did it go?" He says, "Terrible." Everybody was laughing. She says, "Good, tomorrow you're going to go again." She says, "What? Yeah, you're going to go." He goes over there, everybody's still people, but 90% laughing. Then little by little, came the one of the days, after a week later, only one person who was new in town was laughing at it. But afterwards, everybody got used to it. So Rabbi Akiva Shizrat tells him, you see now, everybody got used to it, they stopped laughing. And eventually people, everything passes by. Air comes over. He says, don't worry, it'll be just fine. Go to Heder. He went to Heder to learn to look what he became. He became one of the Mosrei Torah. Rabbi Akiva was Doresh. Tirei Tirim Shel Halachot Mikol Tak Shel Batorah. Can you imagine what Kohen Gadol Batorah he became? Because he overcame these things. So people who are in the city for more than 30 days, already everybody knows already. Nah, it's already nothing to, no reason for our curiosity to be around, and therefore people will go ahead and say, you know, don't bother looking at them at all, and everything will be perfectly fine, and they could go ahead and do Birkat Kohanim, no problem at all. Wonderful day.